Welcome once again to The Breakfast on PLUS TV Africa. Our first major conversation for today is talking politics and, of course, the third force idea. There, of course, has been little bits of clamor here and there. You know, we've seen, of course, Professor Patu Tomi, Atahiru Jega, and a few other people come together and make mention of the possibilities of a third force. Nigerians have also stated, and just like Ezekiel Yanyatok mentioned, that a lot of Nigerians are tired of the two major political parties in the country today, the APC and the PDP. But a lot of questions have also risen as to if the third force really can ever be strong enough to create enough political noise and, of course, win an election in 1 year plus a couple of months. We're speaking this morning with Tanko Yunusa, who's the head of media and public affairs for the National Consultative Front. Good morning, Mr. Yunusa. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me. Good morning, Nigeria.
Great to have you on the program. All right, so I'm going to start with, you know, you sharing your thoughts on where we currently are and the idea of a third force. Of course, this always happens. This happened late 2019, or sometime in 2019, really, before the elections. Eventually, that fell apart. Where they had the internal issues, internal scrambling here and then, you know, that didn't go far. But we're back here again with the idea of a third force. Would you agree with those who say that this is really just a waste of time?
No, I totally disagree. Because particular position, then you would take them back into memory lane of how did the APC come about. It was through this kind of same agitation when people were not satisfied with what the ruling government was doing after that time. Then discussions arising from different groups, and then eventually what we had was an APC emerging from a conglomerate of a new PDP, ABGA, CPC, ACN, and then other political parties. We eventually become the APC. So you see, if it can happen at that period in time, then it can happen in no distant time. And I'm glad that you made mention to the fact that these discussions started in 2019. And these discussions have been ongoing for a very long time. And as of today, it has germinated into a very concrete discussion, starting from a platform, discussion with eminent Nigerians who, of course, many of them have been in the field too, if you can remember very well. My humble self, I was the chairman of the Inter-Party Advisory Council. I was the chairman of all political parties in Nigeria. And that to tell you that I have a depth of knowledge as regards to what the political parties' feelings are. And so eventually when we come to a discussion with different individuals, intellectuals, talk about captains of industries.
All right, it seems we may have lost him, but of course, as we try to reconnect and hope that he connects us immediately, the conversation is about the third force, you know, and where Nigeria seems to be headed. And of course, Tanko Yunusa, as he has just said, you know, mentioned that just like in 2019, or in 2015 rather, you know, there are still those possibilities of it happening. There's still possibilities of, you know, a couple of people coming together. Political forces coming together and, of course, being able to make some sense and, you know, maybe win the elections. Mr. Yunusa, welcome back. Kindly go ahead.
Yes, as I was saying, now this discussion started from a platform, a social media platform, and then individuals come to agree that there's a need for us to actually come up with something new that will resonate with the people. And that will, of course, bring about discussions with different groups, political parties. Let's have a program. This time around is not about a program that we as a political circle want. No. What does the people themselves want? What is their need? What are they asking leaders to do for them? And this, of course, is what we are going to sell to the people. It's only when you get information from the people and you know their feeling, you know their pain, you know their pain, then you'll be able to connect with them. And that's where we come to agreement, and I'm glad. So far, so good. We've been able to discuss. At the moment now, there are about 18 political parties being recognized by INEC. But don't forget, there are other political parties that are registered And there's a court decision that many are expecting by the end of, probably end of this month or early November. But we have had contact with 18 political parties who are not in government, that is except of the PDP. They too realize that, look, they can't do this alone. They need to get work together with others. Some of them are ready to collaborate. Some are ready to match. Some are ready to just be on the fence. But we've been able to identify those who are ready to work together as a team and those who are ready to match. And so very soon, we will make our known to the Nigerian people, and then we will tell them exactly, this is where we want to go together. And then we are working together to ensure that we give Nigerians what they want. And in fact, argument has even gone beyond the thinking that it is not even a third force. The idea is that they say, look, we don't even have a second force because the PDP and the APC is not different from five and have a six, have a seven. So they are even one. We are thinking, well, they are looking for a political party that will resonate with the people, that will give the Nigerian people what they want, and then it will connect and give Nigerians the right kind of the most force are yearning for. As a second force, no, even not more, not a third force.
Okay, let's also talk about the fact that, I mean, the APC and the PDP, amongst other parties, it's not like you don't have other political parties in Nigeria, but they have been dominant because, I mean, if you look at the political economy of these parties, they do have the finances, they have the finances, they also have, you know, the political structures across the 36 states of the Federation, right? So do you think that Paraventure or any of this movement, you know, becomes a political party? Do they have the structure? Do they have what it takes? You know, the structure across the different parts of the country. I mean, the grassroots, because these elections are not just won, you know, by just saying, oh, yes, we're a movement, or, you know, you have people who are very prominent. But we're talking about numbers now. Do they have the recognition, grassroots structures? Do they have the muscle, the financial muscle? They have the finances, you know, to pull through? Can you hear us, please?
Okay. As I told you earlier on, in the platform, we have political parties, we have groups, we have individuals, we have associations. Now, each of these associations and groups have their structure down the line, even to the world level. Don't forget, as I told you, political parties who are registered have their structures down the line. So imagine, just put on an imagining cap that if all of these groups, at least let's even assume that half of them come together to their people, to the grassroots. So the number is large, very, very large. At the moment now, we're even talking about building the structures from the zonal level, dovetailing to the state level, and going down to the world level. So we can, as a movement, if I can get our access to our data, we can boast of each of these particular zones. For example, in the Northwest, we have like 7 million people. For each, it takes 1 million. From Southwest, 6 states, 1 million. So each of the zones come together will have about 36 million people working together as one. So the number is enormous. But we are trying to get the accurate data before we make our pronouncement to the Nigerian people so that they will know the sense in which we are really building.
Mr. Yunusa, can you clarify, when you say 7 million, you say 1 million, are you saying members of your movement or you're saying people who are aware of, you know, your movement?
Yes, target for the minimum target for each of these states is 1 million per state. And we are working already to get that particular data to say Northwest has 7 million people.
Can you clarify once again, because we lost sound there, 7 million registered members of your movement, of your party?
That is exactly what I'm saying. Each state at the moment now, each state And that is a fact. So we are trying to work together with eminent Nigerians who are going to collaborate with them to ensure that the zones are working, to ensure that we are in with that 7 million, for example, Northwest, and then 6 million from Northeast, North Central, 6 million, and then South-South, 6 million, Southwest, 6 million, and Southeast, 6 million. That will give a total of 6 million.
Well, Mr. Yunusa, these are very interesting figures, you know, and you know, anyone who hears these, you know, very likely would be excited about these numbers, because even Nigeria's elections over time hasn't been able to, you know, provide 35 or 36 million voters, you know, all at once. So it's interesting to see that you have these figures, and of course, like you said, you're going to confirm. But do you think that you have these numbers, these millions of people all registered? And is that also going to be another stumbling block for you? How many of these, you know, 36 million that you're projecting are fully registered to vote and would be willing to vote when you give, of course, whenever your party gives a go ahead with a candidate? Is that also going to be one of the stumbling blocks? And second is, and I'm asking this because I heard something from Dele Momodu yesterday, what something that he put out, the possibility of a merger with either the PDP or the APC. Are you also open to such a conversation? If the PDP says, okay, we see that you have a good movement, we see that you have a nine structure, we would like to come together and do this movement together. Is there also a possibility that that can work?
Let me go down the line with the statistics that you just mentioned. Accurately, we had a registered voters in 2019 about 88 million. Out of 33 million people voted, and leaving about 55 million. That's at 2029. Now, imagine that 55 million registered voters who did not vote. So at that particular number, we have enough to even move forward. Is multiplying even now. Remember the Ensign movement, who are the majority of the Nigerian youth, who are so aggrieved with the way in which governance is being administered to them.
Yes.
We are working with them. So talking about our movement, we are working with political parties, working with either groups of Ensigns, working with other groups. So the number is large. So don't even, we're only being modest with our numbers. But as I said, when the data comes out, we will actually give you an accurate number. But what we are trying to do is that this is the first time we are even mentioning our numbers, because we didn't want to mention it at all. But it has been this time that we start to tell Nigerians the sense in which we are holding. And there are other groups too who we are working with. Now, to come to your questions as regards to whether APC or PDP make an advancement towards us, the idea is not about the PDP or APC. We are talking about talking to Nigerian people. We want to give Nigerian people what they request for. And so, working with the APC or PDP is not on our table at the moment now. Because if the Nigerian people have gotten what they wanted, they wouldn't have been agitating for a third force or a second force. Okay. So the Nigerian people are looking out for something new, something different, and what we are ready to give to them. So the issue is about a program for the Nigerian people, which they are demanding for. In fact, you could understand, any group that comes out now and make a speech, without even making pronouncement that it's a party, the next thing that the president will just say that it's a political party, that's to tell you how eager Nigerians are.
Okay, so the closest election to us right now is the Anambra election, hopefully on the 6th of November, 2021. Is that going to be a thought for us in that election?
No, not at the moment. We have not really synergized with the actions or in what has taken place in Anambra, but we are putting these issues on the table too. We want to look at it if there's a possibility of talking to all of our members of our group that we're together to see what can we mobilize for Anambra. We don't want to use Anambra as a test case. There are other elections that may come up even before the general election. When we have full permission, we can put that those ones as a test case for our group. But at the moment now, we can confirm that we are going to use the groupings for the Anambra election, not at the moment.
All right. So, I want to also speak about one of the things that I've seen, people reacting and, describing as one of the fears concerning the possibility of a third force. And that is the fact that a lot of the electorate really, most times aren't, politically aware enough to make these decisions. Third force might have very brilliant personalities. I've seen Pato Tomi, I've seen Donald Duke, I've seen Kingsley Moghalu, I've seen Tahiru Jega, that you might regard as very interesting political figures, brilliant minds. But the electorate across Nigeria, and of course mostly northern Nigeria, may not really care about some of these persons. So how do you plan to also, what are the possibilities of defeating that aspect? And also, the fact that there's still some level of voter inducement in Nigeria's electoral process.
Okay. Before I go into the issue of mobilization, let me make a quick clarification so that some of these personalities will not be mistaken for what their intentions are. Some of the groups that you've seen come up, like Donald Duke, Tahir Jega, and our eminent Odisha Agbakoba, yes, for Donald Duke, he has come out. The first group that you saw them with were talking about good governance. They were not being partisan. And I think Donald Duke came out and made clarification with regard to that. Who is an eminent scholar, is a member of the PRP. Of course, he belongs to our grouping. We are part of eminent leaders. Who, of course, is currently in the movement we are galvanizing, and these people are talking about issues. And so until when we come to that position of political formation, we need a little bit of a clarification as with regard to that, so that people will not say probably we are dropping their name for any political.
Understood.
With regard to your question, like I said, and then probably exposing some of the strategies in which we put in place. But I can tell you what we intend to do is to harness all of our strengths and weaknesses, putting them together, and look at how we are going to move. That, of course, means that, for example, if an AA, for example, or ADC, we're not building from the top, we are building along the world. If you understand that, what that means politically, that is our target. Because you need to have your strength. It's like a pillar. If you don't have a strong pillar, you will not be able to build a duplex or one-story building. It will collapse. So we are building from the grassroots. And we want our leaders who are interested in this particular movement to help in continuously to build itself from the world. We know that Nigerian people are tired and waiting. In fact, people are even thinking that we are wasting too much time. But we need to make sure that every technicality that needs to be collected is done before we make pronouncements. So that is where we are at the moment. And that's the most I can tell you, so that I will not be able to, I may not be accused of divulging strategic moves. But we are working very seriously.
Okay, but some political elements are saying that there's a tendency that monetized politics might just play out, as it always happens all the time. A situation where, on both ends, where you have those who are part of this movement who will be worried by those who have the resources, maybe from other parties. I can categorically mention which party will come forward, to try to get those who are part of this movement to go to the other side. And also, on the other hand, you have the electorate falling for the crumbs, those ones who are impoverished. And so at the end of the day, you find out that the third force movement might just be another failure. So do you see that playing itself out ahead of the 2023 elections?
Well, we are trying to take all the mix together. We don't want to rule out the fact that people will be filled with money, even among us. We want to. We are looking at money and probably be offered to them. There's not. It's not impossible. But what we intend to do is that as politicians and the activists, we want to look at credible people who are ready to go with Nigerian people. And I'm sure the Nigerian people who have been this particular kind of failed leadership have seen the difference from them taking Maggi and collecting 5,000 naira and then collecting, you know, rappers and all others have seen the results. So many of them may not want to go the same way again. But to be very fair to every Nigerian, we don't want to lose track of some of the challenges that have undermined the emergence of credible leadership in this country. Because it is the result of that particular form of collecting small change that has led to we having very bad leaders in the country. So every Nigerian who is interested in good leadership should know that any attempt whatsoever to collect any peanut will result in decay in the system. And I don't think Nigerians are ready for such a failed leadership. And that is the reason why they have been agitating for a new form of leadership that is credible, a leadership that can be purposeful, a leadership that is objective, a leadership that has empathy, that belongs to the people. And that is exactly what we are interested in giving to them. So we will ask them to look beyond the issue of money politics. We are not saying that we are the best. They can even bring us some of the best among themselves to come and contest under the leadership so that they can win elections and do what they have been preaching. It's not about you sitting in your bedroom complaining all the time or sitting down around a newspaper vendor and looking at all the headlines and making all kind of comments. No, this time around, everybody must be on board. When you make a decision, bring up your best ideas. Let's work together to salvage this country because this country needs us now, needs everybody.
All right. Well, Tanko Yunusa, there's a lot more, you know, angles here and that I wish we had time for, but unfortunately, we would have to let this go and, of course, bring you back again as quickly or as soon as possible so we can also explore the avenues concerning the possibility of a third force between now and 2023. So thanks anyway for joining us and for sharing your time with us this Thursday morning.
Thank you very much for having me.
Wish you a great day ahead.
All right. Many thanks for joining us.
All right. We'll move away from there now and move, you know, our conversations away from, you know, well, national politics and focus on Anambra State, where elections, of course, are coming up in just about a month or less. We're going to be talking about the November 6th elections and the possibilities of having free, fair, but most importantly, peaceful elections in Anambra. We'll be back.